biggest blessing I think we all have is my grandma used to tell this to my mom, and my mom would tell it to me. They go, Stevie, if you have your health, you have everything. You know, back when growing up, I'm like, yeah, right, get out of my head here. But the bottom line is if you do have your health, you do in fact have everything. Because without your health, you're screwed. One of the barriers to success in not just starting a lifestyle where people become healthier is not just the attitude, but it's the ability to forgive themselves for the failures that they have. And by failures, I mean the times where you wake up at midnight, like I do, and basically gorge yourself on food from the fridge or whatever. And yeah, I'll do that because sometimes I'm just burning so many calories, I'll just binge. And some people go overboard with it to the point where they almost feel like they've eaten themselves sick. Then they become frustrated with themselves. They become hateful of themselves, and they feel like giving up, that there's no use. And guys, I'm going to tell you straight up, you can't go there. You can't do that. You've got to be able to forgive yourself when you screw up completely. And why? Well, one, God said he wants us not wounded. By forgiving yourself, that wounds away. If you're Catholic, go to confession, or however you guys do it. But if you're wounded, you're not going to be able to do his will as effectively as he wants. And maybe his will is for you is, you know, getting healthier. Maybe that's what it is. Maybe your struggle, our struggle with weight, really is an opportunity to bring yourself closer to Christ. I'm not making this up. Closer to God. So forgiveness is an essential component in a successful lifestyle where you want to get healthier. I'm going to go into Duke Energy here and pass out some flyers. So when you binge eat and you screw up, you know what? It might be a lot. When you're first starting out in this program, you might screw up a ton and just eat yourself sick, or you're burning calories, you're starting out and you're getting nothing more than just constantly getting pissed off at yourself for screwing up. Or maybe you struggle with drugs or alcohol. Acknowledge the fact that you screwed up. Say you're sorry, but forgive yourself. That is a total important. Matter of fact, in some of my other videos, I mentioned, I think it's Isaiah chapter 1, 19 to 32, when one of the apostles asked Christ, he asked, how many times must I forgive my brother if he sins against me? 7 times? And what does God do or Christ do? He says, no, 70 times 7. Guys, we're mortal. We're going to screw up. You're going to start this exercise program or this healthy lifestyle called aerobic house cleaning, and you're going to go for days and be perfect, and then one day you're just going to find yourself feeding your face, drinking yourself to a blue, whatever that might be. Oh, you know, okay, fine. You did it. Cockeye happens. And it may happen again. It may happen more and more. But maybe over time, it happens less and less and less, because as you do this program and you start to understand the importance of being healthy, not just for you physically, but for your emotions and yourself spiritually, maybe those binges become less and less and less as you get healthier. And that's what I'm hoping that the Aerobic House Cleaning Lifestyle DVD and eBook does for you guys. If you can't afford it, if you really can't afford it, send me $5 and I'll send you a copy of the DVD that'll cover the, actually won't cover the costs of the DVD production and the mailing. But you know, if you really can't afford it, but you want to lose weight, email me at steve@aerobichousecleaning.com or go online. we'll figure something out. But I really do want to get the United States healthier, because like the Centers for Disease Control said, it's an epidemic. Getting out of that epidemic, attitude and forgiveness are going to be essential elements in the success of that. So learn to forgive yourself, be kind to yourself, be kind to others. Sometimes, doesn't mean that you can't get pissed off. You know, living this healthier lifestyle, a good attitude and forgiveness, absolutely you're going to get ticked off. Absolutely. You might get so pissed off you could explode. It's part of it. That's part of life. Not the total part of life, but it's there. So don't worry about it. Good luck. For a number of years, I taught Christian doctrine to third graders, and it really helped me learn a lot about the message that Christ had. And this applies to folks who are heavy. Matthew 9:13, God says, "Go and learn the meaning of the word." Mercy. Sacrifice is good, and that's good. Sacrifice is good, but mercy is what pleases me. Now, how does that apply to folks who are struggling with losing weight? Because not only do we have to be merciful to others, but we've got to be merciful to ourselves as well. It is absolutely imperative that for us to be fruitful, we've got to have mercy and forgive ourselves for when we screw up. And I'm talking about the binge eating or the drinking or if you're doing drugs, whatever that might be. But you've got to show mercy, because it's funny. The more merciful we are with ourselves, I'm convinced, the more merciful we can be with others. We can't use that as an excuse, though, and lie to ourselves and say, "Well, you know what, I'm not going to work out this week, and I'm just going to eat my face off, and I'm just going to eat and do nothing and lay on the couch." That's bogus. That's a sin. That's a big sin. Because then you can't go, "Oh, I'm sorry for it," because you're really not sorry for it. But if you're really sorry for it, forgive yourself and be merciful for yourself. Be merciful to yourselves. Ourselves. And remember, that's Matthew 9:13. That's one of my favorite quotes from scriptures. Matthew 9:13. Sacrifice is good, but mercy is what pleases me. That's pretty outstanding. Check it out. Good luck. A quick heads up on the issue of mercy and forgiveness. The next time that we are standing in front of our refrigerators or our cupboards, staring at food, getting that feeling in your brain and in your mouth that you just want to just chow down, do one of two things. Try and satiate ourselves with a glass of water, fruit, and walk away from it one time. If you're doing this, you know, binging 2, 3, 4 times a week, try one time. One time. Just walk away. That's it. One time. One time. It's tough. I know. Trust me, I know. It's tough. Or, number two, instead of eating a whole friggin' bag of cookies, like my buddy said, he ate a dozen donuts. Remember where we were sitting in the de-ice truck at Delta Airlines? He said he ate a dozen donuts, Krispy Kremes, and he was disgusted with himself. I mean, he hated himself. He was that mad. He hated himself. Substitute that food. And I'll get into this in much more detail later when we talk about foods. But substitute bad calories for good calories. And literally, if you have to, go buy a case of beans, peas, whatever, fruit, vegetables, and eat those. It'll kill your appetite. And you'll have eaten good calories instead of lousy calories. It's simple, it's effective. When I used to kickbox, one of the essential elements was that we keep our weight down and our strength up. had to do that. And I found out that by, and don't laugh, I still do this to this day. I'll take a bottle of Frank's Red Hot hot sauce. It's my favorite. Tabasco is probably a darn close second, but, and I take the bottle, I pour it into a little glass, probably about 2 ounces of it, and shoot it. That kills your appetite. Big time. So, it's called calorie substituting. Anyhow, try that, guys. Try it one time. Because once you've proven it to yourself that you could do it one time, you've proven it to yourself that you could do it as many times as need be. Real simple. Good luck. I'm going to go to the CVS Pharmacy and the Covington Police Department. Drop off some flowers or Domino's. I know you're asking, hey, Steve, you're talking about eating good and not eating bad. Because when I get to talk about the reward days, my reward days are where I've been on my trellis for 7 hours working out or yard work, whatever. And if I want to eat an entire large pizza, I'm going to do it. That's my reward. Knock back a couple of beers, that's my reward. Driving around, looking at the different demographics, the different socioeconomic levels, I sometimes pinch myself and say, I'm blessed. Sure, I don't have a job per se, but I am beyond blessed that I have my health. I've got buddies who have had open heart, who basically are probably going to die unless they change their lifestyles. They will die. They fall into a funk, kind of like self-denial, that maybe, you know, if I don't acknowledge it, if I don't acknowledge the fact that I'm overweight, the diseases that are caused by being overweight won't affect me. That's burying your head in the sand, and it's a very, very dangerous way of thinking, very dangerous attitude, because it ultimately leads to a very long, protracted death, often caused by diseases related to diabetes. So, you know, we make our own choices, guys. We do what we want to do, and everything else is an excuse. But a lot of the folks, a lot of my buddies, they find it hard. They find it hard to change their lifestyles. And I understand what they're saying, and I know what they mean. But you cannot fall into, what was the one emotion that God said don't fall into? I think it was being, what's the word, forlorn. God did not want us to be forlorn or desperate. He didn't want us to become desperate. Desperate. Hopelessness. You gotta have hope, guys. He does not want us to go there. Ah, I know what the word is. Despair. That's the word. God said, do not fall into despair. So for all of you and all of us who are struggling with being overweight, do not fall into despair. Work on it. Do what's right. Have hope and have faith. And it's not a goal, not a short-term goal, where, you know what, I'll do this for 3 months or 4 months. No, man, this is going to be for the rest of your life, the rest of my life. Every single day, it's the best thing you can do for yourself. Live right. Adios. Okay, I am almost done for the day, but just a couple of, something to leave you guys with. If for those of you who are really, really struggling with losing weight, please consider listening to some of the spiritual folks on the radio. You've got Dr. Dobson, you have a number of AM stations. Insight for Living is one of them. If you're Catholic, there's something called Sacred Heart Radio. And a lot of the folks on there talk about helping heal those who are broken. And by broken, I mean are at their wits' end in dealing with certain types of challenges that they're facing in their life, whether that's alcoholism, drug addiction, no matter what it is, obesity, can't lose weight. Oftentimes, the solution, a real lasting solution, is not going to come from out in the world. It may be residing in a spiritual walk with God. And I know I bring up scripture a lot, and I'll get teased a lot for that. But the bottom line is this, folks. If you're struggling and nothing's worked, and I'm wondering, 200 million Americans cannot get into better health, cannot lose weight, you know what? Try God. Read the Bible. Read what it says. Listen to some of these men and women on the radio who've had some extremely hard difficulties to overcome. They tell their story about how their life improved once they had or found their relationship, their personal relationship with Jesus Christ, and what it meant to them, not just in overcoming their challenge, whether it's alcoholism, drug addiction, being overweight, obese, but understanding that that is going to be a path for them. And they know that, and they live that, and they live that every day. And there's your comfort. You're not going to be comforted 2 years from now when you lose 50 pounds or 100 pounds. You're comforted the moment that you begin your walk and your relationship with Christ to solve your problems. Tell you what, if you don't believe, give it a shot. At least give it a shot. This will be my last blog on forgiveness for today. And in, next week's video blog, not sure exactly. I think I'm going to be talking about foods and overcoming, or just simply eating better, getting away from unhealthy foods, and why that's so, so important, especially the high fructose corn syrup, which the bottom line of that stuff is crap. But I'll go into that more later, as well as a couple of other things. You guys take care of yourselves. Love yourselves, be merciful to yourself, forgive yourself, and enjoy your life starting now. Right now. Not later. Now. Right now. Take care. Alright, folks. For those who are heavy and are trying to do something about it and nothing's working, if you're looking at this video, I'm going to encourage you to get the Aerobic House Cleaning DVD and the eBook. And the eBook is basically a 175-page PowerPoint presentation that's packed with tons of information. I'm going to encourage you to do it. Try it. If nothing else has worked for you, try it. What have you got to lose? What have you got to lose?